ransom for many. And this is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Brothers and sisters in Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who said, "What is it you want me to do for you?" Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Excuse me one moment. And there was no water at the pulpit, and I just kept coughing.
death anymore. When I think about a ransom, I think about the redemption law that was passed in Iowa about 40 to 45 years ago. And I can remember when I was in high school, we had to do a recycling project at home ec. Whatever we wanted to do, we had to use recycling materials. So I walked about a quarter mile up the road from our house in the ditches and picked up enough cans to make a little table, a solid core table. You can't do that so quick anymore because the ditches aren't littered with all those cans. I can remember when I first moved to California, they didn't have a bottle law. And so when you had a can and you used a can of soda, you threw it in the garbage. And I remember my then 6-year-old son, Brian, fishing it out of the garbage and saying, "Oh, we throw nickels away now." And I had to tell him, there's no nickel here. But I think about that, that when we talk about redemption, we are purchased by the blood of Jesus Christ. We have been redeemed. We have been brought back. We have been bought back by the Creator of the universe, who loves each and every one of us with a passionate love, where all he did was serve others. And we, as followers of Jesus, are to do that too. In the night in which he was betrayed, he washed the disciples' feet, his followers' feet, as they came in the room. He washed their feet. This is how you're supposed to treat one another. When you have a religious leader trying to have all kinds of power and speed at them, you realize that they're not in God's will, they're in their own will, they're in the world's will. Whenever you have a religious leader that forgets that their first and primary focus should be to serve their flock, to serve their heavenly Father, to serve everybody who they encounter, then you suddenly see how grotesque and unworldly and ungodly these religious leaders the sky